What's up, everybody? This morning we're gonna try to catch some cattle and run them through the chute, work the calves, vaccinate them. We're just gonna band them today. I'm not gonna cut them. Give them all their vaccinations, brand them, tag them, worm them. And it'll be fun. The wind is blowing so bad today though, and it's been blowing like this for the last 10 days straight. I mean, it's been terrible. So there's no way I'm gonna be able to film this with the mics. I might do some time lapses, but unfortunately I'm not gonna be able to get any of this filmed right. So I will just do the best I can. But that's what we're doing today. I got my vaccinations in the cooler. I got ivermectin back there. Wormer, dewormer, I guess I should say, and we're gonna fight this wind. I wish I had some sunglasses or something to keep the dirt out of my eyes because it's gonna be blowing. But I'll do the best I can and get what I can on film. We're gonna have a lot of people out there helping us, so not everybody wants to be on camera, of course, but see how it goes. Spraying. The wind is already bad enough probably not to be spraying, but it's supposed to get a lot worse as the day goes on. It's not that bad right now. It's probably 15 mile an hour right now, but they're saying gust up to 45. The last week there's been gust up to 70 mile an hour out here, and the wildfires have been bad. We're so dry and it's been a mess. Hopefully, fingers crossed, we don't have any fires break out around us. We've been very fortunate so far, but our local fire departments, our local volunteer fire departments, they need some help. I've thought about trying to make a little fundraiser or something because it's bad. I mean, they're going through equipment like crazy. They can't keep doing this every day, but they have worked their butts off this year, so. Anyway, it's not just around here either. It's the entire state of Oklahoma and Texas. And it's everywhere else too, I'm sure. But North Texas, Southwest Oklahoma, all Western Oklahoma, it's bad. So anyway, I'll quit rambling. Got this lot set up in four pins with the octagon in the center. We're running them through here. We've been worming them, tagging them, branding them. Got our back box. These are my dad's cows. And then we own all four corners right here, so we're running them right back across the road. Those red ones we worked for ran right back across the road over there to that pasture, and we're gonna run these back across over to that pasture. And then we got some to work over in that pasture and the one here too. sorry we didn't get much footage of, other than time lapse of all that, but battery died on the GoPro, so we got done, worked those two pastures there, got those other two to do there, and then I got one, two more as well, so it'll be a lot more footage of working calves and stuff. Everything went pretty good. I didn't get on camera, but had one mad mama, because we separated her. Some of them calves are pretty small, and let her out of the chute after we worked her, and my niece was on the backside of the gate, opening up the gate, running them back into the lot, and that cow turned on her, so I ran up there to help her, and that cow turned on me, and came and hit me, and knocked me up into the pickup and the fence, and about broke my dad's mirror off his pickup. Nah, I didn't get hurt or nothing, but I wish I would have caught it on camera. Better than my niece getting hurt, but it wasn't no big deal. But we got it all done, headed to the house now. I was checking some more cattle on the way home, but everything looked good. The only bad thing is we are in this severe drought right now, you know, with the wildfires and everything I was talking about. If it didn't rain pretty quick, we're going to be in some serious trouble with our cattle too, because these ponds are going dry. Luckily for me, everywhere I have my cows at right now, I have rural water except for one, and I'm putting in the run rural water to this, a half a mile to this place. It's actually this place right here. I'm putting in for that next month, this month, so hopefully I'll get that done, and I'll be okay. My dad has a lot of cows with no rural water, and I'm hauling water to some, but man, it's a pain in the butt, so we're hoping. Fingers crossed we get a good rain soon, because it's getting pretty scary. This happened to me in 2011. We were in a terrible drought in 2012. It was awful. Went 100 plus days over 100 degree temps with no rain in the middle of summer. Everything was burning up and dried up. And I had just established my first cattle herd right out of high school. Took me a couple years and had to sell them all because of the drought, so I hope that doesn't happen again. That's the last thing I need. So, for everybody's sake around here, and it ain't just here, it's just, it seems like everyone's in a drought. It's not good, so. It goes in waves though, it'll come back around, it'll come back, probably flood when we aren't expecting it, so. Anyway, if I, have anything else I'll share with you guys. I was looking right here. Looks like I got a new baby calf here. I should just spit it out. That's good. Looks like she's doing good. I don't know if y'all can see that way over there. She's eating the afterbirth right now. I can't zoom in, but anyway, hopefully, pray for rain. The other day on my last two videos, I never did like an exit on the videos. That's all for these videos. So, I guess you can like or subscribe or ignore. I don't know. I'm new to this. You don't have to do anything. Like and subscribe. Follow me for more of this. Keep digging.